Welcome to Introduction to Healthcare and Public Health in the U.S., Financing Healthcare, Part 2. This is Lecture A. The component, Introduction to Healthcare and Public Health in the U.S., is a survey of how healthcare and public health are organized and how services are delivered in the U.S. It covers public policy, relevant organizations and their interrelationships, professional roles, legal and regulatory issues, and payment systems. It also addresses health reform initiatives in the U.S. The learning objectives for Financing Healthcare Part 2 are to describe the revenue cycle and the billing process undertaken by different healthcare enterprises, explain the billing and coding processes and standard code sets used in the claims process, identify different fee-for-service and episode of care reimbursement methodologies used by insurers and healthcare organizations, or HCOs, in the claims process. Review factors responsible for escalating healthcare expenditures in the U.S. and discuss methods of controlling rising medical costs. This lecture describes the processes that a healthcare organization uses to collect revenue from payers. This includes the revenue cycle in a healthcare organization, or the set of activities and events that produce income for the organization, and the terms and processes associated with medical billing and coding, including code sets. As with other business entities, healthcare organizations must receive income to pay expenses. Managing expenses in healthcare organizations is similar to any other business. However, healthcare is unique in the way in which it receives payment. There are four features that make the business of healthcare different. First, a third-party payer makes the majority of payments to someone other than the patient for services provided. Second, the amount paid or reimbursed by an insurance plan depends entirely on codes entered on the bill or claim that indicate the type of service provided and the reason or diagnosis for the service or services, and a formula determined by the payer. This formula for payment frequently is not transparent. Third, payment amounts received for identical services may vary within a payer and from payer to payer. And fourth, healthcare organizations depend on payment from the government for approximately half of all healthcare expenses in the U.S. The revenue cycle is a standard set of activities and events that produce revenue or income for a healthcare organization or provider. Medical billing, as part of the revenue cycle, is the process of submitting claims to insurance companies in order to receive payment or reimbursement for services rendered by a healthcare provider. Reimbursement is the term used to describe payment by third-party payers to healthcare organizations for services provided. Third-party payers reimburse claims based upon one of two methodologies, fee-for-service or episode of care, both of which describe a unit of payment. Reimbursement methodology will be discussed at length later in this unit. A claim is the healthcare organization's itemized statement and formal request for payment from the third-party payer for the medical services provided to the patient or the insured. An additional definition associated with the billing and reimbursement is charge capture, which is the process of collecting and noting all services, procedures, and supplies provided during an encounter or patient care in preparation for submitting a claim to a third-party payer. The charge description master is the database of prices for services provided to patients and used by healthcare organizations during the billing process. Electronic Data Interchange, or EDI, is the structured transmission of data between organizations by electronic means. The Health Insurance Portability and Accountability Act, or HIPAA, of 1996 established national standards for electronic healthcare transactions. A transaction set used during an EDI is an electronic model of a paper transaction or form. The revenue cycle is a standard set of activities and events that produce revenue or income for a provider. Each organization determines the administrative and management tasks pertinent to their particular operational circumstances. The tasks for a serious case in the emergency department of a hospital will be handled differently than a direct admission to the hospital, as will the tasks in a physician's office. In each situation, the process of the revenue cycle is the same. The process begins with the patient or provider determining that healthcare services are needed and scheduling an appointment. At the healthcare facility, demographic information and insurance information are collected when the patient registers. The healthcare organization confirms the terms of the insurance coverage with the third-party payer, either electronically or by telephone. During this process, the provider obtains information about patient deductibles, co-payments, and co-insurance. The healthcare organization then provides services to the patient. Documentation of the services furnished and the diagnosis associated with each service occurs during charge capture. Subsequently, during coding, the diagnosis and services are converted into alphanumeric or numeric codes in a claim and are submitted to the third-party payer for reimbursement. After processing by the third-party payer using the appropriate methodology, the provider receives a remittance advice, adjusts its accounts, and makes its final settlement on the account with the patient. The next slides examine select aspects of the medical billing process and the revenue cycle. Today, hospital management or practice management software accomplishes most billing tasks electronically. During the registration process, the software allows the accurate capture of patient demographic and health insurance information. This allows the provider to confirm eligibility and enrollment in the healthcare plan, effective dates, benefits, and limitations and exclusions. It also permits the determination of deductibles, coinsurance, and copayments. Acquiring the correct information ensures accurate reimbursement. Without accurate information, a third-party payer may be unable to identify the patient or insured, resulting in a denial of payment for services provided. During the course of delivering healthcare, the charge capture process gathers descriptive data about the services provided during an encounter, including diagnosis, procedures, and tests, in order to establish an accurate representation of the services provided and the costs associated with them. The actual fees charged to a patient account can be found in the organization's Charge Description Master, a database used by a healthcare facility that stores the price list for all services provided to patients. Smaller providers may use paper-based forms in the charge capture process, which may be called a superbill, encounter form, or charge ticket. Large organizations with sophisticated information systems can electronically capture charges using their management software. In addition, charges for services extrapolated from patient electronic records can automatically post to the patient's account, which improves accuracy. Charge capture is essential to ensure the healthcare organization or provider properly bills and receives reimbursement for the healthcare services provided. This becomes all the more important in what's called episode of care reimbursement. Briefly, in episode of care reimbursement, a provider receives a single fee, no matter the services and the costs of providing the services. Since the cost of providing services may exceed the revenue received using this reimbursement method, providers must collect an accurate representation of the cost of providing the service using charge capture. In other words, providers must evaluate if they have taken on too much risk or cost in providing care in this reimbursement methodology. By tracking charges, the provider may terminate or renegotiate the contract for reimbursement in the event that costs exceed revenue. Episode of care reimbursement will be discussed at length later in this lecture. After the services provided by a healthcare facility have been documented during charge capture, a claim can be prepared for submission to the third-party payer by coding the claim. Coding is the process of translating the descriptive or written diagnosis and procedures relating to a patient encounter into a standard numeric classification or code, accomplished by using code sets. Code set refers to any table or group of codes used to encode data elements during the medical claims process. A code set may include a table of terms, medical concepts, medical diagnosis codes, or medical procedure codes. A code set includes the codes and the descriptors of the codes. The International Classification of Diseases, 10th Revision, Clinical Modification, or ICD-10-CM, is the new diagnosis coding system developed as a replacement for ICD-9-CM, Volumes 1 and 2. The International Classification of Diseases 10th Revision Procedure Coding, the ICD-10-PCS, is the new procedure coding system developed as a replacement for ICD-9-CM Volume 3. The compliance date for implementation of ICD-10-CM for diagnoses and ICD-10-PCS for inpatient hospital procedures was October 1, 2015. ICD-9-CM codes are very different from ICD-10-CM-PCS code sets. There are nearly 19 times as many procedure codes in ICD-10-PCS than in ICD-9-CM Volume 3. There are nearly 5 times as many diagnosis codes in ICD-10-CM than in ICD-9-CM. ICD-10 has alphanumeric categories instead of numeric ones. The Health Insurance Portability and Accountability Act, or HIPAA, of 1996 requires that providers use specific code sets when submitting claims. This slide lists some of the code sets used to report medical services. The list also includes the organizations responsible for each code set. Two of these deserve further discussion here, the ICD-10-CM and the Current Procedural Terminology, or CPT. ICD-10-CM is based on the World Health Organization, or WHO's, International Classification of Diseases 10th Revision, or ICD-10. ICD-10-CM is the official system of assigning codes to diagnoses and procedures associated with hospital utilization in the U.S. The National Center for Health Statistics, or NCHS, and the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services, or CMS, are the U.S. governmental agencies responsible for overseeing all changes and modifications to the ICD-10-CM. ICD-10-CM for medical diagnoses is based on WHO's ICD-10. CMS also developed a new procedure coding system, ICD-10-PCS, for inpatient procedures. ICD-10-CM replaces ICD-9-CM Volumes 1 and 2, and ICD-10-PCS replaces ICD-9-CM Volume 3. The Current Procedural Terminology, or CPT, code set is maintained by the American Medical Association through the CPT Editorial Panel. The CPT code set describes medical, surgical, and diagnostic services and is designed to communicate uniform information about medical services and procedures among physicians, coders, patients, accreditation organizations, and payers for administrative, financial, and analytical purposes. The National Drug Codes, or NDC, are developed by the Federal Drug Administration, or FDA, and drug manufacturers. Also, the American Dental Association develops specific codes for dental procedures called the Code on Dental Procedures and Nomenclature, or CDT. HIPAA standards require the use of specific code sets for submitting claims, depending on the provider and the location where the service was delivered. The code sets for physicians and hospital facilities are listed here. The ICD-10-CM is used to report all inpatient and outpatient diagnoses. The CPT is used to report physician inpatient and outpatient procedures. The ICD-10-PCS is used to report inpatient facility procedures. And the Healthcare Common Procedure Coding System, or HCPCS, is used to report outpatient facility procedures. An example of the data available in the ICD-10-CM code set is illustrated on this slide. Under Diseases of the Circulatory System, ischemic heart disease is listed. Under that classification are the three-digit codes that describe an acute myocardial infarction. From there, the code for the specific type of myocardial infarction can be indicated. Note that this list is just a small sample of the codes available for ischemic heart diseases. An example of CPT surgery codes for the external ear are listed on this slide. Some examples of converting a diagnosis and procedure into codes for a physician are illustrated on this slide. The diagnosis of upper respiratory infection converts to J06.9 using the ICD-10-CM. A level 2 new patient office visit codes as 99202 using the CPT. And a skin biopsy converts to 11100. Immune globulin 10 mg given as an injection converts to J1564 using the HCPCS level 2 codes. It is important to have trained personnel who are knowledgeable about coding in order to properly code a claim. This concludes Lecture A of Financing Healthcare Part 2. In summary, the revenue cycle for healthcare organizations is a unique process that requires submission of medical bills or claims describing the services provided. During the preparation of claims, information about the type of medical service, the diagnosis associated with the service, and the fee for the service is gathered and coded into a claim using standardized codes. The final piece of the revenue cycle, submitting claims, is covered in the next lecture.